A very special guest. Hello, Caterpillar. Oh, hello, baby bird. Don't you two look elegant? What are we celebrating? Of course. Merry Christmas, everyone. So, everything ready? Oh, I see. You're waiting for Pocoyo. I wonder where he is.
Ay, ay, ay. Hi!
Hey, slow down! Look where you're... Ah, careful! Oh, Pocoyo, look! Well, there were, but you'll have to look behind you. Well, we'll just tell Ellie that there are no ornaments for the tree and...
Never!
I should think so. It's a footprint, and it's huge!
Look!
Yes, and there are no more ornaments from where the enormous footprints start. Follow those tracks. We have to get them back. Great idea, Pocoyo. Tickle it some more.
Yeti!
Yes, it's a Yeti. A friendly Yeti.
Lula, no! Yeti's my friend.
I think he's very excited to be your friend, Pocoyo. He says his name is Yanko. What an interesting name for a Yeti.
Pocoyo. Lula. Come, come here, friend.
Ellie, Pato, don't be afraid. It's just Pocoyo and...
Hi!
No, don't worry. Pocoyo's still got all his fingers and toes. Yanko wouldn't hurt a fly.
No! Yanko's a friend.
I'm afraid that Pato and Ellie feel that you're too big to be their friend. You see, Yanko may be big, but he has an even bigger heart.
Yanko, Yanko!
Hooray for friends, and hooray for celebrating all together. Happy Christmas. See you soon.
Happy!
Hello, Pato. What a lovely day to care for your plants. Oh dear. Pato, it seems someone shut the water off. What was that? Pato. Pato, please slow down a bit. You say you saw a little green creature like this one? She says her name is Nina. Why not introduce yourself, Pocoyo?
Pocoyo!
And this is Roberto. Hello, Nina and Roberto. It seems she's never shaken hands before. Pato. An umbrella? But it's not raining. So, you've seen Pato before.
You were playing with your friend the ladybug, and Pato came. He watered the plant, and you got all wet. Oh, but Nina, I'm quite sure Pato didn't mean to get you wet. Pato was just watering his plants to help them grow. Yes! Because he loves plants more than almost anything. She says that anyone who loves plants deserves a hug. Oh, I see. That's to warn Nina whenever Pato waters the plants. Brilliant! This calls for a celebration. Roberto, would you? Why, hello there. We haven't seen you in a while. You must be going to visit your friends. Oh, I see. So you want to take over the world again. And just how do you plan to do that? I'm afraid I don't understand. Through the use of a complex device, you've managed to create a remote control that, when you activate it, exchanges everyone's mind so you can ruin their fun and so dominate the world. Well, that doesn't sound very nice. Oh my! That thing works! You're really the angry alien? Oh dear! Well, that's a lovely painting, Pato. Yes, thank you. You've made Pato's painting 1,000 times better. Uh-oh, Pocoyo. Caterpillar thinks you're the alien. And it seems she fancies you. I'm sorry, Miss Caterpillar, but that's not who you think it is. No, I'm not joking. That's not the alien. It's Pocoyo. It seems Ellie's lost in a good book. Well done! Ellie's never gone so high. That's another nice thing you've done today. Oh, I understand. You want to switch your body back? You want to fix this situation? Phew! I hoped you would.
Yay!
So, if you think about it, I'd say you really did conquer the world. You made everything better. Well? Wonderful! This calls for a celebration.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Well, what have you found there, Pocoyo? You don't know? Can any of you tell Pocoyo what it is?
Caterpillar!
It's a caterpillar!
Cat-a-pillar!
Here comes Ellie. Oh, watch out! Good thing you came along, Pocoyo. Looks like your little friend needs someone to look after it. Caterpillar's interested in those leaves. Well, caterpillars do like to eat. Oh, what a lovely cake Pato's got. Oh, where's it gone? And this caterpillar has quite an appetite. What's next on the menu, Pocoyo? A table? I don't think the caterpillar will eat it. Oh, well, it really is very hungry, isn't it? And it's a lover of books, too. Sorry, Pato, Ellie, but Pocoyo's little friend just can't seem to get enough to eat. Looks like your little friend has been here.
Caterpillar?
You know, Pocoyo, with all its eating, your caterpillar friend is changing. Yes, it has made a cocoon for itself.
Cocoon?
Yes, a cocoon is a sort of sleeping bag, big enough for it to rest in. Can you see anything that looks like that, Pocoyo? Yes, Pocoyo, your friend is in there. Thank you, Dr. Pato. When your little friend comes out of the cocoon, Pocoyo, let's just say you'll be quite surprised by what it will change into. Oh, what was that? I think I can see Pocoyo's friend. Can any of you see what Pocoyo's little friend has changed into?
A butterfly!
A lovely butterfly.
Yes, the caterpillar has turned into a butterfly. Well, Pocoyo, your friend has certainly changed. Oh, the butterfly's hungry too. Well, Pocoyo, your friend has certainly changed, but it still has the same appetite, and it still seems to be your friend. Hooray for Pocoyo! See you soon! What's that sound? It looks like a visitor from space. Maybe we can all say hello to him. Ready? Here we go.
Hello, Alien.
Oh, dear. He seems a bit shy. It's okay. It's okay. You're among friends, little green alien. Welcome to our planet. Is this your first time here? Well, then, let's introduce you to some of our friends. By the way, you do come in peace, don't you? I think you're going to like our friends a lot. Oops, what's that? Oh, it's Pocoyo. Oh no, wait, Pocoyo. Pocoyo!
Hi.
I want you to meet someone. No, no, he's above you, Pocoyo. Pocoyo, our friend is very shy, so we need to be very kind to him.
Hi,
That's better. Pocoyo, remember? Kind. Can any of you tell me who that sounds like?
Pato! No, Pato!
Oh no, his hat is stuck over his eyes again. Pato! Pato! Stop, Pato! You're scaring our new friend! Wait! Phew, that was a close one. But where's the alien gone? Oh, there you are! Look, I'm terribly sorry about that. Pato is really not like that normally. Let's meet Ellie. There's nothing to be afraid of. She's really very nice. Oh, dear. Oh, this is unfortunate. Uh-oh. Oh, this is really not good. Hello, little friend. Here you are. Oh, look, it's Ellie and Pato. You see, they're completely harmless. Do you think Pocoyo and the alien should go and say hello to Ellie and Pato? Well, that didn't go well at all, did it? Don't worry. I think you just gave them a fright. Ah, here they come. Everyone, I want to introduce you to your new alien friend. He comes from outer space. See? I knew once you got to know each other, you'd all be the best of friends. What's this? Oh, this must be his parents. Perhaps they've come to take our little friend home. Your son is such a nice little boy. We've had a great time with him, Mummy Alien. Oh, I see. You're Daddy Alien. Oh, dear. Our friends are about to leave and Pocoyo and Ellie aren't here to say goodbye to their new friend. It looks as if they're leaving now. Oh, what a shame. Did you see that? Oh, look! It's Pocoyo and Ellie. They've come to say goodbye. Let's all say goodbye to the aliens with them, shall we?
Bye!
Hooray for new friends! Bye-bye! Come back again soon! Hello, sleepy bird. Oh, sorry. You go back to sleep, sleepy bird. Oh. Ah, hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Ah, come to see your old friend Sleepy Bird, have you? I'm afraid she's asleep as usual. Oh, wait a minute. Is she waking up? Oh, no. I think it's something else. Oh, my word. Oh, that was so close. Pocoyo? It's not actually a... Thank you, Pato. Yes, I suppose it does look like a ball, but it's shaped a little differently. Oh, I know. Can you help Pocoyo? Can any of you tell him what that is?
Egg!
It's an egg, Pocoyo!
Egg! Egg! An egg!
Phew, that's better. Eggs can break, I'm afraid, Pocoyo, if you're not careful. And do you know what's inside that egg, waiting to come out? Ah, Pato knows. There's a baby bird inside that egg, Pocoyo.
Baby?
That's right. I had no idea Sleepy Bird was sitting on an egg. That egg belongs up there in Sleepy Bird's nest with its mother. Oh dear, you'd best catch it, Pocoyo. Sleepy Bird will be very worried if she wakes up. Oh, there it goes! Catch it, Pocoyo! Pato, you catch it now! No, it's coming the other way! Quickly, quickly! Pato, it's behind you! Oh, my word! Oh, well done! Now, if we could just get Sleepy Bird's attention. Sleepy Bird!
Sleepy Bird!
Sleepy Bird! She certainly is a sound sleeper, isn't she? Nothing wakes that bird up. I suppose we'll have to find a way to get it up there ourselves, then. Yes, I'm afraid it is quite high up, Pocoyo. Perhaps we need someone taller to help us. But who? Can any of you tell Pocoyo someone who is tall enough to help us?
Ellie!
That's right! Well done. That's where an egg belongs, snug in its nest. Hooray for Pocoyo! Something's happening to the egg.
Egg. Egg.
Oh, don't worry, Pocoyo. Come closer now. You won't want to miss this. a little sleepy bird. Or a little not-so-sleepy bird. Well, in any case, it looks like we all have a new friend who we'll be seeing more of. If we can catch him, that is. Bye-bye. See you soon. Hello, Pato. Now, what on earth is that? Can any of you tell Pato what that is?
It's an egg,
Pato.
It's a big egg.
Ah, you're right. I see. It is an egg. Fascinating. Oh, hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Oh dear, but... No, Pocoyo, you and Ellie have the wrong idea here. You see, that's not really a ball. What Pato has is an egg. And very soon, something will happen to that egg. It will hatch. Now do you see why that egg is so special to Pato? Oh dear, it's time, it's time. It's... It's a spider! I suppose ducklings aren't the only things that hatch from eggs. And some people are frightened of spiders, even baby ones. I'm afraid you've given Pato a fright, baby spider. Baby spider isn't that scary, Pato. And he seems to like you. There's Pocoyo and Ellie. Hello! Oh dear. I reckon they're still too scared to play with you as long as baby spider is around. Baby spider, Papa Pato, has a game he wants to play. He wants you to count all the stones you can find. I suppose you can go and play with Pocoyo and Ellie now, Pato. Ah, baby spider found a stone. Papa Pato says keep counting. Tell Pato what baby spider would like to do.
Play ball.
Play!
I think you're right. He wants to play. Hello, baby bird. Oh dear. Pato says, take the pencil and go and do some colouring, baby spider. What's this? Can any of you tell Ellie and Pocoyo who did that nice drawing of them? You're right. Aw, that's so sweet. See? I knew once you got to know each other, you'd all be the best of friends. Hooray for Pato! Hooray for new friends! Bye-bye. See you soon. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
What have you got there?
Train.
Oh, splendid. Hello, Caterpillar. Hello, Pato. Hello, Ellie. Hello, baby bird. Hello, sleepy bird. Oh, what's this? It looks like a spaceship. And it's heading right for Pocoyo World. I do hope they're friendly. Well, at least they're polite. Oops! There's no reason to be scared, Pato. It's okay. Oh, dear. It seems quite taken with you, Ellie. Oh! Pocoyo, Ellie and Pato have something they want to tell you. They've just seen a spaceship. There it is. There. Pocoyo doesn't believe me. Will you tell Pocoyo where the spaceship is?
Behind you. It's in the back.
Yes, there it is. Look.
Pocoyo Brave.
Pato is also very brave. Oh, look! Why, it's a car. A teeny, tiny little car. They're aliens. Way! Acrobatic aliens. Oh. Really, really friendly. Wow! Let's all clap for our new friends. What's this? Oh, I see. It's the Martian Brothers Circus.
Circus?
Yes. Don't you know what a circus is, Pocoyo? Yes? No.
Circus.
Incredible! It's a circus! Yes, Pato, it is rather small. The space zapper. Oh my! It's a full-size circus! Oh, it looks like Pato has found the space zapper. Oh dear, it seems if you push the wrong button, you could destroy the entire universe.
Circus.
Oh, I see. Our friend says they need to practice first, so we'll have to leave. What's that, Ellie? You want to stay and watch? Well, perhaps if we all ask nicely, they'll let us stay. Ready, everyone?
Please, let us watch.
We want to.
Oh, goody! We can stay! Presenting the strongest alien in the galaxy! Ellie says your weights are very cute. They're so tiny. Oh, my! Bravo! Let's all applaud. And now, for our next act, the death-defying high dive! What's that, Pato? The high dive is too short. Apparently, that water is very cold. And now, the grand finale! That was terrific. Let's all applaud the Martian Brothers.
Hooray!
friend here says it's time to put up some posters for the show. Of course, the vamoosh! Pocoyo can take you in the vamoosh. I wonder what Pato and Ellie are up to. Ah, hello, Ellie. Hello, Pato. Pato? Is that the zapper? But, the Martian asked you not to play with it. He said bad things could happen. No, Pato, you mustn't. Oh, dear. Ow! Oh, dear. Pato, stop it, please! Oh, I wonder where Pocoyo is. Ah, all finished. Good job. Now we have to get back to the circus. Oh, it's an angry alien. I wonder what they're up to. What? It's the ultramagnetic 3000 magnet! This doesn't look good at all. It seems angry aliens like circuses too. Very good, Pocoyo. Now, there's plenty of time to get ready for the circus. Oh no! The angry aliens found the circus without you. Mr. Martian says someone has been playing with their things. They're all the wrong size. And someone has taken the zapper.
Ellie, Pato?
Ah, there they are! And they're making everything bigger! Oh. Oh, no! Ellie doesn't like people messing with her doll. Oh, this is getting out of hand. Somebody do something, please.
Stop!
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, thank goodness you're here.
Naughty, naughty.
Will you return the zapper? Thank you, Pocoyo. I don't know what would have happened if you hadn't arrived when you did. You're not thinking... Run, Pato! Faster! Oh no! The circus aliens have been shrunk! And you've broken their zapper! And there's a tent full of angry aliens waiting for the show.
That's no problem.
What's that, Pocoyo? You have an idea?
Ta-da!
You say you'll do the circus? Right. Ladies and gentlemen, for our first act, we have... Fred, you're on.
It's the juggler.
Hit it, Fred! Good show! You're a hit! And now, in the center ring... Pato the Clown! Seems angry aliens don't like tap dancing.
Ellie.
Oh, yes, the mighty Ellie. Wonderful. Thank you, Ellie. For our grand finale, we have that avian of the air, Pato!
assisted by his somnambulant sidekick, Sleepy Bird. Joined by that magnificent millipede of the motorcycle, Caterpillar. Along with a winged projectile, Baby Bird, and Lula, the fierce lion. And Fred, not to forget, Fred. And on the high dive, Ellie. And blindfolded, we have Pocoyo. Oh, no! I can't look. The zapper is fixed. Bravo! Hooray for space circuses! Hooray for helping new friends! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Pocoyo and Nina's Terror Show.
Look, here come our friends. Hello, everyone. Where are you going? Oh, I see. You have tickets to Pocoyo and Nina's Halloween Theater. How exciting! Wonderful.
Everything's ready to raise the curtain for the big show.
Pocoyo, Nina, the audience has arrived. Are you ready? Great. Then let the show begin. Didn't seem to scare them very much. We have a very tough audience today.
Plan B?
Ah, Pocoyo and Nina have prepared a much more terrifying alternative plan. Nina says that now the true spectacle of horror and fear begins.
Pocoyo!
Thank you. Pocoyo? That's incredible!
This is really scary.
But who's moving those skeletons?
Nina!
But, Nina, are you the one who's controlling those puppets?
Pocoyo!
Pocoyo? But if it's not Pocoyo, and it's not Nina either, then who's playing Spooky?
Theater group Los Hermanos Chihuahua. Theater, birthday parties, baptisms, and burials. And that's their business card. So this dance show is part of your artistic repertoire. It looks like it's time to leave.
The show must go on. But far, far away from here.
This adventure has been frightfully terrific. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, Pocoyo.
I'm not Pocoyo. Super Inventor Pocoyo.
Oh, I see. You're a super inventor. Super Inventor Pocoyo.
Yay, 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 yay.
And would you show us any of your inventions? Wow! That's such a great gadget! What's it for?
Oh! Broken!
Oh, I see. It's broken. Oh, there you have another new device. What's this one for?
Not finished.
Pocoyo, I wonder if you might have any other inventions? Maybe one that is finished or works? Oh, okay, that way. Wow, that's amazing! A super invention! Whoa, it's a teletransporting machine! would you give us a demonstration? Great! Pato, Pocoyo has built a machine and we'd love to try it. We were wondering whether you'd, if you'd like to help us. I see. This is another one of your gadgets. Incredible! It's a mind-reading machine. Reading Pato's mind, we'll find out if he wants to take part in this experiment.
Pato says yes!
I'm afraid we've run out of volunteers. Well done, Ellie! We've got our volunteer back!
Yay!
That's weird. He should have arrived by now. Oh no! The machine has a virus and Pato is stuck inside. We've got to help him get out. Caterpillar, we need to bail Pato out. As soon as Pocoyo signals us, we need to push this button and bring our friends back. Well done. We just need to find Pato now. But this world is huge. We're never going to find him. Oh, there he is. And the virus is after him. Run, Pato, run! Virus! It's fallen apart! Oh no! It's getting put back together! What do you mean, Pocoyo? Oh, it's time to signal Caterpillar. All right, I'll take care of it. Caterpillar, do you remember what Pocoyo explained before? Good. Now you need to push the button. No, no, focus, Caterpillar. This is really important. You must press the button. No, Caterpillar, not that button. You must trigger the red switch, the one marked with the arrow. No, Caterpillar, you need to focus. Come on, Caterpillar, the big button, the red one. That's right, Caterpillar, the red button. No, no, Caterpillar, you need to press the button. No? But, Caterpillar, we need to bring our friends back. Phew! Just in time. This has been really exciting. Oh, the virus, it's still there. Well done. That's much better. Great. Now let's keep enjoying new adventures. Hello, Pocoyo. Hi, Nina.
Hi.
Having a picnic, I see. Mmm, and something smells good. Oh, cupcakes, Ellie. I bet you worked hard on them. They look marvelous. Well done. Oh dear, Ellie. And you worked so hard. No cupcakes today. What a pity. A machine that can take you backwards in time? Oh, so you can go back to before the cupcakes were smashed. Brilliant! But how's it work? Incredible! We've gone back in time a whole minute. Guys, aren't you forgetting something important? No, Pocoyo, the banana peel. We can't let Ellie slip on it again. She's coming! Hurry! Tuck in. You ate them all. Oh, I see. You'll just go back in time again and have a second helping. But, oh dear, where are we? Yee-haw! We're in the Old West. But it looks like Miss Ellie isn't making cupcakes.
I'd say that now we're in prehistoric times. Aha! The banana peel, of course. Last, you're back in the present, and just in time for the cupcakes. Oh dear, hard luck, guys. You're a bit late. No, wait, there's Ellie. And she made more cupcakes just for you. Bye-bye, everyone.
They go again. Can any of you tell me who those two are?
Pocoyo and Baby Bird.
You are right. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Baby Bird.
Hello.
So, what are you planning to do today, Pocoyo?
Pato.
Oh, yes, there's Pato playing with his blocks. Let's play! Well, that was fun, wasn't it? I suppose it's time to tidy up a bit now. Where did they go? This must be a mistake. I'm sure they won't leave you to clean up this mess all by yourself. Ah, Caterpillar is finishing a puzzle. How nice.
Play.
Yay!
Oh dear, that wasn't much help, was it? Ellie and her doll are going for a picnic. Ellie, special biscuits. Ellie's going to get you some more. Those do look delicious. What a mess.
Bye-bye.
Pocoyo, you do realize that your friends are very upset with you, don't you?
Pato!
You see? You don't have any idea just why that might be? Yes, Caterpillar is also upset with you, Pocoyo. Tell Pocoyo why his friends are upset with him.
He made a mess. He's messy.
It's true. Messy. Remember Pato's blocks? And Ellie's picnic? And, of course, Caterpillar's puzzle? Maybe you should apologize. Pato, Ellie, Caterpillar... There's someone who wants to tell you something.
Sorry.
Can you help Pocoyo say his sorry to his friends? One, two, three.
Sorry!
I think we should give him another chance, don't you? This is very odd. What could he be up to? Oh, I see. Pocoyo has framed it for you. Oh, that's marvellous. Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for friends! Bye-bye. See you soon.